Hi, I'm Analytical, your friendly neighborhood drag queen and top-tier tech educator. Today, we're going to look at some memes. I think when you're learning to code, humor is a great way to stay up to date on what's happening, to be in the know, laugh about it with your friends, laugh about it with the online tech community. I mean, that's a great way to learn. Some people are even dressing up as clowns to teach people tech, and can't relate. All right, we're going to Reddit, we're going to programmer humor, and we're going to look at some of these memes. And I think some of them are going to be really good. I think some of them will learn a little bit. That's the goal. Goal learning. Some of them are probably going to be a little toxic, and maybe we'll skip over them. Or we can discuss why they are not good. And let's just go in. I'm going to go over top for at least the week, because, you know, we don't need to sort through the drudges of stuff. So we've got a screenshot from LinkedIn, and this is basically, there are so many recruiter emails that you'll get. If you're just learning to code, do not worry. After your first internship, after your first year of computer science at college, you're gonna start getting emails like this. Hello, Mr. Lytical. And yes, they'll probably misgender you. So be prepared. We are looking for Java, PHP, Python, React, Angular, Postgres developer who knows how to do everything for a junior development role. And it's just silly because they want you to do everything. They're not going to pay you well. And they don't even take the time to research who you are. So this is a good meme. I like this one. And also, just something to mention, people always talk about, oh, I got recruited to Google, I got recruited to Facebook, and then you, like, hear these stories about someone who's getting just plucked off into the air, and that's not how it works. So if you're starting computer science or starting your journey, don't feel like, oh, I'm not getting emails from recruiters. Literally, a recruiter is just going to email you to apply via the online form. Maybe it'll get you through the process a little bit faster, but no one's just getting hired based on random projects they're working on. There's always going to be an interview. Everyone is going through that same process at any company. So I never want you to feel like, oh, I'm not like these people that are getting plucked off of the ground for recruiting. No, that's not how it works. Those people are spreading lies. Okay, how to get a job as a machine learning engineer. So they're an expert in machine learning. It's 9 plus 10, it's 3. And it's a 19. And they're guessing it's 16. Wrong, it's still 19. It's 18. And they say it's 19. And it's 19. Okay. I like this one too. I'm glad we're starting with the top, with the best. In machine learning, there are a bunch of different approaches to determine what your algorithm is going to be. You're not just saying, oh, I built a machine and it's going to do smart things. There's always an input and an output you're looking for. So here, the joke is that the input is 9 plus 10. And you want to get to the output of 19. A good way to do this if you have a lot of data is you just take a bunch of guesses and you see, is this data, are my guesses correct most of the time? And if they are, then you can adjust your machine learning model. It's kind of like a function. If you ever had a bunch of points on a graph, you draw a line through them. It's like the best fit line, but in like a million dimensions at once. And you basically keep adjusting this line until you get close enough or you get correct a certain amount of time. So basically, they're readjusting this line to what is the answer and showing like, oh, I can do machine learning just because I know how to adjust the answer. A plus meme. I honestly, I'm so glad I didn't look through these before. Okay, end of 2019. This is a New Year's meme. And I want you to take a second and think like, have you seen anything like this before? Does this remind you of anything? Any of my other tutorials? Go look on my channel. This is an HTML meme. HTML, if you don't know what HTML is, it's basically an outline for a website. You say, I've got headers here. I've got a paragraph here. I've got a list of data here. I guess if you're on Reddit, you've got a list of all these posts. You'll have an image tag. And each tag, you'll put the data in. So maybe for a large header, like programmer humor, you put that in a heading two. And you start that off by saying H2 in these opening, closing, less than, greater than. So you put H2 in there, you put your text, so programmer humor, and then you put another set of V's, you know, greater than, less than. And then you put, but you put a slash before the end. So this is basically saying we're wrapping up 2019, mixing a little bit of programmer humor in there. All right. When you write code without reading the documentation, but somehow it still works. All code has kind of a set of instructions of how to use it. Let's say you're trying to build an iPhone application and Apple has created a list of instructions on how to build an iPhone application, lots of details. A lot of time it's like, you, when you get a new car, you're not going to read the manual, but you're just going to kind of figure it out and hope it works for the best. And this is basically what's happening here. There are so many times where I'm programming and I'm like, I'm just going to fiddle around with it till it works and maybe it'll get there, but I don't know. And then you end up with a situation like this where it's like, okay, I've locked it, but in the dumbest way possible. Okay. Not that good. I love this. We've got a conditional statement, IRL. If you're low enough to hit that sign, that means the bridge is lower and you're going to go through both of them. That's good. A great way to like learn about if conditions. So in JavaScript, we would say if, and then we do parentheses. I don't know, maybe you hit the sign. How could we do that? We could do sign.hit, kind of maybe a little bit like object-oriented programming. Go check out my object-oriented ASMR tutorial or video. Or if it isn't out yet, be waiting for that because it is something. And then bridge.hit. We could put that in there in the curly braces and bam. You just learned a little bit about conditionals. Okay, I'm not reading that. That's too much. Okay. Like this one. This is about, you know, programmers. We start counting at zero, not at one. You know that if you've taken Beyond Binary with me, link in the description. It's my little computer science course. We go through a few of the basics of programming. And we know in binary, you start counting at zero. They've kind of started the staircase at zero. Hey, Kelly Vaughn. Hey, shout out. This is totally me. On your first day of coding and your 10,000th hour of coding, some days you're going to feel like, oh my God, I am such a genius. Can't believe I figured that out. Can't believe I aced that interview. I'm an expert. And then other days, your brain is going to be fried. You're not going to know how to do for loop. You're not going to know how to do an if statement, how to declare a variable. And don't fear about that. That happens to everybody. It happens to me. That happens to Kelly. Don't let those days bring you down. You have to get rest. You have to take time to digest the information. I was just listening to the Code Newbie podcast, and one of the people that was on was saying he teaches Udemy courses, and people watch the whole thing at once, but no, you have to space it out. In most classes, you don't just learn all the math at once. You don't just read all the books in one day. You have to take time to process it. So take time to process the code. Take time to step back from your computer. Go have a coffee. Go have a mocha latte. Go apply your lipstick. And take your time. Okay, I like this one. So when you're programming in Terminal, and I should definitely do a Terminal video. Terminal is this bad thing right here. You've probably seen it in all those hacker movies. It's only the command line. It's all the text. And it's scary. And we can make this glam. We can do whatever you want. It'll be so good. But in Terminal, all of your previous commands can be accessed by just using the up arrow. So I've got cd documents, I've got Python, and you know, doing some stuff with Python, which is fun. So basically this person has to go all the way up. They did this command at one point, so they're just searching through all of their history to find it. Okay, let's do a few more. You know, sometimes you just gotta relate to the memes. It's just gonna make you feel good about yourself, like the one we saw with Kelly. It'll just make you feel good to know other people are having your problems. And, you know, just talking to other people about their problems. If you're learning to code online or just in like an online class, you might feel so lost. You might feel like, oh, I can't do it. I don't know what I'm doing. But other people feel that way too. So memes are a great way to express all those struggles you're having. And if you make any programmer memes about your struggles learning to code, please send them to me. I will retweet you. I will put them on the Instagram, all at the analytical. This one, we're going to end on this one because I saw this one, like when I guess it came out 14 days ago. binary and non-binary are both half-assed. I don't even know why I waste my time doing that shit. People struggle with it, so it's not half-assed, as your transphobic post is trying to say.
That was about programming.
Again, you know on this channel we love binary, we love non-binary, code, the genders, all of it. Because we're making programming an we're not making it an exclusive place, we're making it an inclusive place for you, for me, for all these memes. That's all we've got time for in this video. If you like this video, leave a like on it, comment, subscribe, ring the bell, post any of your memes, post questions about memes, and maybe I can go through them all in another video and share them to me, you know? All right. Bye.
Boo. Boo. Boo.